Hello, welcome again. We are solving some conventional questions of heat transfer. The topic is radiation. Question number 103 from Engineering Question Mains 2023. A truncated cone has top and bottom diameters of 10 cm and 20 cm respectively and a height of 10 cm. Calculate the shape factor between the top surface and the side, and also the shape factor between the side and its center. Use the figure showing the radiation shape factor for radiation between two parallel coaxial discs. So these are the two discs. The bottom disc is having radius r1 and the top disc is having radius r2. L is the length between or coaxial distance between them. This figure, the horizontal axis of this figure is representing L by r1 and vertical axis is representing f1. And these lines are corresponding to R2 by L. R2 by L is 5, 6, 5, 4. Okay. Now it is given that the top diameter is 10 cm and bottom diameter is 2 cm. So R1 is 5, R2 is 10, and H is 10. Okay. So these are the data. So L by R1 is 1, L by R2 is 2. R2 by L is 0.5. Now we can use L by R1 and R2 by L for the figure. So R2 by L is 0.5. R2 by L is 0.5. Okay. And L by R1 is 1. So corresponding to this, we get F1 to F 0.15. Okay. So this is the point. So this is approximately 0.15. Okay. So F1 2 comes out as 0.15. Now we know that if we take surface 1 and consider all the possible shape factors, then the summation of the shape factor should be 1. The possible shape factors are F11, F12, F13 from considering surface 1. So that should be equal to 1. As 1 cannot see itself, so F11 is 0. F12 we have calculated, obtained from the graph, that is 0.15. So F13 is 0.85. So by reciprocity theorem, A1 F12 A2 is equal to A2 F21. So A1 is pi r square or pi into 10 square, and A2 is pi into 5 square. Okay. A1 is pi into 10 square and A2 is pi into 5 square. A1 is area of part 1. Part 1 is your top of top surface and R1 is your bottom surface. A1 is your bottom surface, that is having radius 10, and top surface is your 2, that is having radius 5. So it is pi into r square, and this is also pi into r2 square. So from this we have f12, that is 0.15. so f21 is 0.6. so f21 comes out as 0.6. so this is the shape factor of top surface with bottom, so that is f21. Now considering surface 2, from the surface to the summation of all the possible shape factors should be 1. So F22, F23 and F21 should be equal to 1. As you cannot see itself, so F22 is 0, and F21 we have calculated as 0.6, so F23 comes out as 0.6. so this is the top, the shape factor of top with side. So this is the answer to question number 2. So now considering surface 3, this is your surface 3, called side portion. So again F31 plus F32 plus F33 should be equal to 1, and A3, this side part area, surface area, is given by the formula pi R1 plus R2 into S. R1 is 10, R2 is 5, S is root 10 square plus 5. This is your 10, this is your 5, because this is whole is 10 and this is whole is 5, so this is 5. This is L square plus 5, 10 square plus 5 square root. Okay, so this is your A3. So now by using the specificity theorem, A3 F31 should be equal to A1 F13. We know A3 and F13 we have calculated. F13 is 0.85. F13 is 0.85. Okay. So we can calculate F31. So F31 comes out as 0.5066. Similarly, A3 F32 should be equal to A2 F23. So A3 we have calculated and F23 is also calculated, that is 0.4. So F32 comes out as 0.05. So now putting the values here, we can calculate F33. So this is the shape factor with side to itself, because it is third part is your side and this is F33, so it is side to itself, so this is the answer to question number 6.